Hello y'all, this is Kaiser Redux, a Kaiserreich expansion that is played standalone. Kaiserreich itself is set in a world where the Central Powers won World War I. We're going to play as Deutsch Madagascar, who was gained by Germany after World War I. It was never meant to be valuable, but the man who has overseen the island wishes it to be more than just a place the Germans control. Madagascar has also been seen an influx of Jewish immigrants who are seeking to flee oppression across the globe. For starring national spirits, we have colonial government, Middle African fleet, and Jewish settlement. While I'm not sure about the first one, the other two focuses give the country some positive effects like naval doctrine, research speed, and monthly population boost. Looking at the army, we have 3 infantry divisions. As for commanders, we have 3 generals and a field marshal who is also our country leader. We are a subject state to Deutsch Middle Africa, which sort of represents and controls colonial holdings of the German Empire in the continent. Reinhard Heydrich is the leader of Madagascar, and historically he was a high-ranking official in SS and police in Nazi Germany, as well as one of the main architects of the Holocaust. Before his time in SS, though, he was in the German Navy, making it to the rank of sub-lieutenant before being dismissed in 1931 for a breach of promise. Looking at the country's military technology, we have basic rifles, no tank research, no artillery research, and for planes, all we have is basic fighters at the start. Beginning our focus tree, let's go with a paradise on the surface, which upon completion will give us an event called the Model Colony. Our only available template for army units is Marine Storm Division, so we're just going to try and make more, I guess. A paradise on the surface essentially just tells us don't go outside the largest cities because the natural landscape has been industrialized to an absurd degree, and apparently workers are being overworked to death. Reinhard Heydrich, since becoming the lord of the island, has started and completed many projects on the extravagant and expensive side, ranging from expansive infrastructural systems to a network of work camps and factories that supply the Kaiserreich. His dream, though, is to make an island-wide naval base. The Model Colony. Madagascar is seen as one of the German Empire's most favorable posts, but on the other hand, due to Heydrich's naval projects, workers' deaths are among the highest in the world, and so far the objective of making the island to a massive naval base has been a failure. The settler situation. Jews have left behind centuries of anti-Semitism to come to our shores. The leader of our country sees them as a source of labor due to the native population being in decline thanks to Heydrich's deluded schemes. After the first arrival of the Jewish immigrants, Reinhard began advertising to the world. Madagascar was open to all Jews across the globe, offering them incentives such as work and cheap housing. In our focus tree, let's begin the focus tree reign of Heydrich so our current leader's reign will continue. Reinhard, or the Beast as he is, quote, affectionately known as by the natives, is nearly always accompanied by one of the most unassuming men in the German colonial mission, named Emil Maurice, the two being friends, with Maurice acting as Heydrich's personal chauffeur. In the decision tab, let's join the Kaiser Wilhelm Society for technology research benefits, and we also need to demobilize our economy, otherwise we will suffer a negative effect if it goes on too long. In our focus tree, let's go down a small branch where a 5-year industrialization plan begins, and then make our way through a few more focuses to turn away watchdogs, which upon completion, Heydrich will secure his control over Madagascar. Checking on the African continent, there is a border conflict going on between the two Rhodesias. Nord Rhodesian is winning for now. In our tree that also happens to have focuses, let's cater to sailors, and then after that, let's put the settlers to work. Disaster strikes at the largest port of Madagascar thanks to short-sighted logistical planning on Heydrich's part. A boiler malfunction causes a series of explosions that claim the lives of hundreds, with hundreds more still missing. Even without the loss of life, millions of marks worth of damages have been inflicted on the port and ships that are docked there. Words of the tragedy reach Europe. Reinhard Heydrich is barraged with mail, but of note, we receive a strongly worded letter from Raymond Aron, a famous French-Jewish philosopher and political critic. He hounds the leader and the administration of Madagascar over the unnecessary deaths of so many workers in the disaster. Heydrich chooses not to respond. Instability and chaos are at an all-time high on the island. The Beast rains down death and destruction upon the land in his pursuit of glory. To stop protest and guerrilla movements from gaining momentum, he begrudgingly decides to institute minor reforms. In the focus tree, we'll do one giant naval base, which gives us naval bases, and then after that, we'll start penal labor colony, which upon completion will modify the 5-year plan. National spirit. Checking in on Africa, the Mau Mau have disappeared and we won't be seeing Obama anymore, maybe. We have finally reached Turnaway, the watchdogs, and then after this focus we'll move to the left branch and start the hub of Middle Africa's fleet. A war has broken out in East Asia. It's the Germans versus the Indo-Chinese Union. We'll be keeping an eye on this conflict. Big move by German East Asia. They were able to successfully naval invade and took Saigon, the capital of their enemy. The next two focuses we'll do in our tree is expel French bureaucrats. Then we'll do the one to its right, which is no cost is too high! Exclamation mark. At this point, I think it's safe to assume German East Asia will win their war with the Indo-Chinese Union. Thanks to Heydrich's previous actions, the French protest outside the colonial capital building, Heydrich has begun to lose all reason. Besides not being exactly much of a good guy to begin with, in a rage, he orders all the protesters to be shot at, afterwards sending out an order to the other colonial centers on the island to do the same with the remaining French bureaucrats. Even though he has near limitless power on Madagascar, the beast must deal with the Reichstag, who has issued a clear and direct warning to him for being far too harsh in his methods. The warning is dismissed, and Heydrich's response to these, quote, false accusations as nothing more than rumor and slander. Thanks to the watchdog's focus completed earlier, he will stay in power without challenge. Faraway news from Europe, Sweden declared war on the Finnish Socialist Workers' Republic. Another interesting thing I spotted is that the Don Cuban Union has fragmented into the Don Republic, Comica, Mountain Republic, and the Cuban People's Republic. We have three remaining focuses in Heydrich's path left, and they are work harder or else dot dot dot, Madagascar's Bond Beast, and finally the last one is, just below that, Vilwagen for Madagascar. That Kaiser Wilhelm Society membership is coming in handy. Russia is expanding by declaring war on someone, and a second American Civil War seems nearby. I think Sweden peaced out with Finland, and now they are turning their attention to Norway. We could have a possible war in the future because France is taking a focus called Demand Halt Savoy. Turkestan declares war on Alash Orta, who is in an unfortunate position because they're fighting them and Russia. Since we're finished with the political part of the tree, we'll start the military portion, which begins with a navy with a colony. Our overlord, Deutsche Middle Africa's stability is in the negative. If it goes too high that direction, it will break up, but there is no guarantee we will see that happen. The Savoyard crisis is resolved. A possible war could have happened out of that, so that would be averted entirely. In the focus tree, let's do what is essentially the army branch, starting with the navy on the ground, and we'll do conscript the settlers. Then after that, cheap guns, and lastly, just below that, Madagascar garrison. As expected, the Indo-Chinese Union is defeated, so that is a grand victory for German East Asia. Checking in on Middle Africa, the instability is still going up, but Goering has been replaced by von Epp. Looking north to Europe, we find out Bulgaria is involuntarily taking part in a reenactment of the Second Balkan War. We might as well go over some of the individuals in Heydrich's government. We already met Maurice, so let's start with Bernhard Rogge, who in our timeline was a German naval officer. Next is Hans Frank, who historically served as the head of the general government in Poland during the Second World War. He later was found guilty of war crimes and crimes against humanity at the Nuremberg trials. Last is Erhard Milch, who is a German field marshal who oversaw the development of the Luftwaffe as part of the rearmament of Nazi Germany during World War II. He was in charge of aircraft production. Looks like one of our ports is being used by a task force from Deutsche Middle Africa consisting of nothing but destroyers. The focus Madagascar garrison gave us a division, and unsurprisingly, it is a garrison division. I guess since the Don Cuban Union fell apart, Russia is going to have an easier time eating all of these smaller nations. Let's see what the other German colonial domains are doing in Africa. Middle Africa is building a railway. Deutsche West Africa is working on a navy. The Nigerian Free State is getting help from Middle Africa. The Congo Free State is making an African army. North Rhodesia is working on the defense of Zambia. And the Kenyan-Ugandan Free State is being a little bit internally violent. The Russian Republic has carved their way through the Caucasus Mountains and found themselves in a conflict with Georgia. The Japanese are invading the Philippines, and the Dominican Republic has declared war on their neighbor, Haiti. The Philippines got annexed, and checking in on the rest of Asia, China is fighting itself, and the Great Mongol Empire has appeared. It's late September 1938, and the focus tree has been completed, at least the parts I can access. There is replayability since there is like four other political paths and some other ones you can take if Middle Africa collapses. Looking at Middle Africa one last time, their stability has gone up a little bit, and the idea of them even collapsing at this point is gone. The video is going to stop here. If you enjoyed the mod, make sure to check it out. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to like and subscribe. Leave a comment. Have an awesome day. I'll see y'all later. Bye.